Hello and welcome to Motorcycle News. We're here at Rockingham today to celebrate amazing two-stroke motorcycles. So first off, we've got this. This is the Suter MMX500. This is a two-stroke Grand Prix bike for the modern day. So you're looking at modern suspension, you're looking at a modern Suter chassis, and you're looking at a 576cc, 188 horsepower V4 that is running fuel injection, that has modern electronics. And the whole thing is combined into being an off-the-shelf track bike, which anyone can buy if they're rich enough. They're €100,000, but when you compare that to an RCV or a BMW HP4 race, it's an expensive bike, but what you get is totally unique. And later, I'll be riding it. We've been hanging on all day because the weather's been terrible here at Rockingham today, and the track just hasn't dried, but we've fitted some wets to it, and I'm gonna go out on a greasy track on some wets on a 188 horsepower bike with no traction control, which I'm quite nervous about. I'm here with Didier Longuet, the mechanic who came over from Suter Racing to help look after the MMX500. Could you tell me a little bit more about the bike? I mean, when did the project start?
When the project started is quite long, because there is the project of between the two brothers Suter, Eskil and Simon. They start to have the idea to make his own 500. Why? Just to have a fun, to have the real light bike with the powerful. So they start to design, especially Eskil on the chassis side and his brother on the engine side, but they make together on the free time, let's say. And free time in Suter company, they have not so much. So finally, after some years, we have to finish this project, because they have always turn around, but we have to really finish it. And finally, we, all engineer and myself and the Eskil and Simon, we really concentrate to finish soon as possible with the late time, because we promised to some customer more early, but finally we finish it just in time to make the crazy project, the TT, 2 years ago. And to be honest, when we arrive in the TT, we are really, really surprised about who is difficult to make the race like a TT. We don't have experience, we have just the circuit experience. And the TT is another world for us. So we discover everything with Jan. Jan make a lot of job to test it before, but the time, we don't have enough. And to be honest, when we start the TT, we are not really ready with the project. But now the bike, we finalize a lot of detail, especially the mapping, because the fuel injection need a lot of tests. Mm. And now we are really ready to sell the bike. We sell already quite a lot. And the customer have it, they are so happy and they have fun. This is we reached the target. This engine with the fuel injection, but at the moment we are really, really happy about the result.
So your own two-stroke fuel injection system from scratch.
Exactly.
That's a tough
we
job.
We start from nothing, and we develop everything around this. Even all the parts of the engine is created by Suter, designed and made and created by Suter.
So you're looking at 188 horsepower at the back wheel.
Yeah, exactly.
We find it.
We find it on the. Of course, our dream is to go at 200. But let's say step by step. Now we have a 190 and we can deliver the bike like it is for the customer. We can produce in, let's say, more or less on 1 week, we can assemble the bike and deliver.
Is this the only production two-stroke road racing bike that you can buy at the moment? There's nothing else because the Japanese don't make them anymore.
No, nobody make anymore. You know, the problem of the homologation and everything. And let's say, for somebody, they believe the two-stroke is dying, but to be honest, no. And it's still interesting because we can create like it is, a really light bike, and with the really fun. And the old character of the engine, let's say like 500, they are crazy, they have no power, and the power coming just now. We have the really good power curve and really drivable, and the best proof is the people have to try, and the people have already the bike. They are not ex-rider of the MotoGP or something like that. They are just normal people, and they have a really fun.
It's amazing. The chassis is very advanced too. It looks very much like the chassis from your CRT and Moto2 bike. Is it very similar?
No, it's not a real. It's, let's say, he have the some family character of the Moto3. You know, in the past we designed a Moto3 chassis for the Honda engine, and after we create the Mahindra machine. And more or less is from this family. But to be honest, this chassis is already designed before we designed the Moto3.
It's an amazing thing. I can't wait to have a spin on it later. It's going to be very exciting. Let's just hope the weather dries up a little bit. Fingers crossed, hey?
I hope so. I'm really waiting for your comment.
Perfect. Come to the end of the day with the Suter. It's been a heck of an experience riding this thing. It's just so impressive in the ways it delivers its power, the way as it pulls from low down, the transition between the mid-range and the top end, which makes it quite manageable even in mixed conditions like this on a set of wets where it's not really wet, it's not really dry, and you don't really know what's going on. It's absolutely brilliant in the way that it just pulls and pulls and pulls and pulls and pulls right up to the 12,500 RPM red line. The chassis is so accurate and stable, and what's impressive about it as well is I've ridden a few really ultralight bikes, and a lot of them have a very aggressive rate of turn in the way that they just fall on their sides. So it's really hard, especially when you're at mid lean on a day like today, to actually hold a proper line because it wants to fall on its side. There's none of that with this. It just steers really neutrally. It holds a line really, really well. It goes exactly where you want it, and you get quite a lot of feel as well. It's a perfectly judged motorcycle, as you'd expect. So obviously, I'm getting nowhere near its limits on a day like today with me at the helm. I mean, with a top rider on this, it wouldn't be that far off a MotoGP bike. It's a very, very impressive bit of kit. But just the way that it gives you confidence is something that was completely unexpected. I thought it would be the kind of machine that would just sort of want to rip your throat off and then laugh at you as your failed attempts to ride it properly. But there's none of that with this. It just drives forward, it's friendly, it's inspiring, and you get little snapshots and little moments that just are just worth, I was going to say worth $1 million, but worth 100,000 euros, which is what this thing is. And there, occasionally you'll blip the throttle and you get a little sniff of two-stroke as you're braking, or you'll be going back through the box, which by the way is really tight and accurate and works perfectly, and you'll be like bam, 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 and you'll be back down to when you were a kid and you're watching Mick Doohan and Kevin Schwantz braking into the Melbourne hairpin. It's a stunning thing, and just to have the time with it today has been a real eye-opener. Thanks to Suter Racing for bringing the bike over. It's been a real experience to take the time with it, and I'd say if you're rich enough, you should buy one.